Hello friends, as everyone knows, currently the novel coronavirus, that is COVID-19, is a pandemic disease spread across the world, and almost every government has initiated lockdown in their countries. In this video, we are going to see some introduction of COVID-19 and is there any significance of lockdown in reducing the number of deaths due to this pandemic. So let's begin. What is pandemic? The pandemic is a disease that occurs over a wide geographic area and affecting an exceptionally high proportion of the population. For example, the flu in 1918 was pandemic and claimed millions of lives. Similarly, the novel coronavirus cases has been confirmed in a large number of countries, due to which the World Health Organization on the 11th March of 2020 has categorized COVID-19 as a pandemic. COVID-19, which was first detected in China in late 2019 and has since been declared a pandemic, threatens to become one of the most difficult tests faced by humanity in modern history. As the confirmed cases of COVID-19 spread, it has the potential to take lives, weaken economies, pressurize the health system, deplete the value of assets, and trigger permanent geopolitical change. The current situation. As the number of new infections reported around the world continues to grow, this chart shows how quickly the virus is spreading in different countries. China's infections have already peaked, yet 39 other countries have only recently passed the threshold of 100 confirmed cases, with more on the way. At the beginning of 2020, the world looked on as China dealt with the occurrence that seemed to be rising out of control. 2 months later, the situation is significantly different. After aggressive testing and quarantine efforts, China's pandemic of novel coronavirus, that is COVID-19, appears to be leveling off. Now, many countries around the world are in the beginning stages of managing their outbreaks. March 15, 2020 marked a significant statistical milestone for this, as confirmed cases of COVID-19 outside of China surpassed the Chinese total. The tracker above by World in Data charts the trajectory of the growing number of countries with more than 100 confirmed cases of COVID-19. Let's see the simulation for what happens when one sick person is moving in a town freely of having a population of 200. We will start everyone in the town at their random position and moving at a random angle. Please see how the slope of the red curve, which represents the number of sick people, rises rapidly as the disease spreads and then tapers off as people recover. Here, we have not considered the parameter death because it totally depends on the immunity of individuals. It will be some part of the figure recover. The current fatality rate for this pandemic is 5.33%, with confirmed cases of 1.1 million and around 59,000 of deaths as on 4th April 2020 morning. Now, the question is, as the number of new infections reported around the world continues to grow, which countries are winning the battle against COVID-19 and which are still struggling to slow the rate of infection? To understand this, let's understand the concept of flattening the curve. Flattening the curve. The first thing you need to know is that our healthcare system has a capacity. We have a certain number of beds, ventilators, resources, nurses and doctors that can take care of people. Passing this threshold is a frightening thought. It could result in selective servicing, meaning doctors would be faced with the difficult decision of who gets treatment and who doesn't. And the result of it, there will be uncontrollable deaths across the world. As on 3rd April 2020, 39 countries have passed the threshold of 100 confirmed cases, with many more countries on the border. By comparing the infection trajectories from the 100 case mark, we are able to see the clear picture of how quickly the virus is spreading within various countries. A rapid doubling rate can spell big trouble, as even countries with the advanced healthcare systems can become overwhelmed by the large number of cases. This was the case in Lombardy region of Italy, where hospitals were overloaded and an increasing number of medical staff are under quarantine after testing positive for the virus. Nearly 10% of the COVID-19 patients in Lombardy requires intensive care. We stressed resources to their breaking point. Since the virus spreads on an exponential level, that could happen quickly. Now, the question is there any way to prevent this? And the answer is yes, it is flattening the curve. If you all work together, we can take steps forward preventing the spread of COVID-19. Washing your hands for at least 20 seconds, social distancing, and thinking of how your actions impact others can all slow down the infection. If we successfully slow down the acceleration of the spread of the virus, the curve will be flattened. This means the same total number of people can get sick, spread out over a longer time without creating pressure on our healthcare system. Now, in countries like India, the government had taken proactive actions to lock down countries for implementing some or all of these measures to help flatten the curve. Like quarantining, encouraging social distancing, encouraging working from home, closing schools and other institutions, placing hard limits on the size of crowds at the events. Now, let's see what happened when forced quarantine is there and some people are following it seriously to adopt strategies like social distancing and some of our population continues to move around. Now, let's see the simulation for what happened when the quarter of our population continues to move around, while the other three quarters adopt a strategy of social distancing. And now, let's see the simulation for what happened when only 12.5% of the people in the population continues to move around, while the other 87.5% of the people adopt a strategy of social distancing. This is the significance of the lockdown in reducing the number of deaths due to this pandemic. This is the goal. Please help and please play your part. For references, I have taken the charts, information and simulations from World Economic Forum, World Health Organization and the Washington Post. I had also mentioned the links for them in the description. And finally, thank you for watching.